Hi, I'm Kit. I'm the other half of dieglacierdie, and this is my little vlog in response to otters from the other day. I'm just going to be answering some questions, and I have a little guest star. My younger brother is here to ask me some questions, so...
Hello, I'm here to ask the questions today. Question number one. Why are you a vegetarian?
In seventh grade, I saw a PETA video, and I couldn't do it anymore. I just decided I was done, and whether or not my family supported me, I was no longer going to eat meat. And since then, I've gone back and forth between being vegetarian and pesco-vegetarian. And currently, I'm pesco-vegetarian because I've been taking care of myself very well in the last couple of years, and not getting enough protein has done a lot of damage, so I kind of have to regenerate and eat some fish. I kind of only really eat a lot of shellfish. So, sorry, I eat fish because they're not cute like the other animals.
Okay, what is a profession or something that you would like to learn that would surprise or shock your family members and friends?
Okay, honestly, this question took me a really long time to think of something that would be predictable for me, because my friends and family know me pretty well, and they know I've switched my ideas around for what I was going to do with my life quite a few times. I wanted to be an artist, I wanted to be a writer, I wanted to do hair, I wanted to be a stylist, I wanted to be a doctor, like, the list goes on and on. I mean, it kind of left coming up with an idea really impossible. But then I started thinking, and I don't know. I think if I was more comfortable with myself, I would be a burlesque dancer, and that sounds really awful. They're kind of like glorified strippers. But, I don't know. I don't know why, but it just seems like it would be fun. And, yeah, that's probably really shocking for some people, but...
Why do you want to share your life with anyone that will listen?
I think this person is mostly referring to my Twitter obsession, and it's not mainly sharing my life with anybody that will listen. It's just a really easy way to keep in contact with people that actually care about what's going on in my life. Instead of like having to text them all at once, I just post a status on Twitter, and of course there are other people that follow me that I don't really know that see my statuses, but I've made a lot of friends, not really, I actually only made like one friend via Twitter, but it's come in handy with talking to people that I never thought I would talk to, and that's been really cool. So it's not so much I feel like I have to share every detail of my life with people that I don't know, it's just, it's fun. I like Twitter.
Why do you care about appearances and what people wear as much as you do?
Okay, face it, no matter who you are, no matter what you tell people, don't judge a book by its cover, blah blah blah, you know you do. Everybody does it. You see someone, you automatically form an opinion of what they're like by looking at them. I just feel like you should present yourself at your best at all times, because appearances are everything. If you go to a job interview, you have to look good. If you look disheveled, they're going to think you're irresponsible. Same thing when you meet people. If you look like you don't care what you look like, then some people think you just don't care in general. And I just feel like you should just present yourself the best you possibly can at all times, because I know when I look good that I feel good about myself, and I think that probably applies to everybody. And not to quote anything, but like Kurt says in Glee, every day or every moment is an opportunity for fashion, so why not?
What is your favorite book and why?
This was a really tough question for me. I read a lot of really influential books my senior year of high school, and I'd have to say out of all of them, the one that impacted me the most was probably At the Shrug by Ayn Rand. Or Ayn Rand. That's how most people say it. I just feel like that sounds funny. Anyways, I feel like no matter how many times you read that book, you can always get something different out of it. And it's ridiculously long, so, I mean, you could read it for a year, probably, and you probably still wouldn't finish it. I just feel like there's a lot that that book has to teach society, and it shaped me as a person a lot after reading it. I realized that there are some changes that I should make in my life, and that book has helped me to become who I am.
What are your favorite bands, and why?
My top favorite always has been, always will be, Jack's Mannequin / Something Corporate / Andrew McMahon. Always. No matter what music comes into my life, no matter what happens, that will always be my favorite, because I have such a deep connection with that, with Andrew particularly, because all of these different bands or different facets of him. I've been listening to him since I was 12, and I'm 19 and a half, so that's a long time to listen to one artist. Like everybody else on the planet, there's always a band that has kind of saved your life, and Andrew saved my life multiple times, and I just really appreciate him as an artist and as a person, and his music has pretty much become the soundtrack to my life.
What's one of your biggest fears?
Fairly easy to answer. I have anxiety, so I'm afraid of everything. But my top two fears, first being dying, and two being alone.
You're almost 20 years old now. What do you plan to do with your life?
Currently, I'm living with my parents, and towards the middle of the summer, I will be packing up all of this disaster that you see around you, or around me, per se, to move about an hour and a half away to go to cosmetology school, because out of all the things I've wanted to do, this is the only thing I have actual natural talent with, and could actually really take me somewhere. So it's a really big and growing industry, and I think it would be a good idea to do that. So that's what I'm doing.
If you had the ability to sing any one song perfectly, what song would it be?
Any difficult to sing song would be awesome, but I would have to pick Defying Gravity from the musical Wicked.
If you could meet any one person that ever lived, who would it be?
There are so many influential people, I cannot say that word, that I would love to meet, but I would have to pick Lady Gaga, and I'm sure there's a lot of people out there that would want to shoot me for saying that, but as a person and as an artist, I think she's just the tops. I think she is just extremely talented, and she tops herself every single day, and I just admire that so much. It's just amazing to me that so much creativity can come out of one person, that I just have to appreciate that, and I would just love to meet her for, like, coffee and just talk about fashion or music or anything, because she's got a lot of opinions, and I think that she could be a pop artist that really has an effect on the world.